Okay, so before this thing can go under, we gotta pause and take off these fenders, and then we're gonna go around, clean up a bunch of the screws and things that were still sticking down from before. I've gotta make up a couple pieces of one-by material where it had rotted out, and I think that's it. And then just generally get all this metal and trim and stuff that I put here to keep track of where it went, get it out of the way, and then we'll bring this thing under. Alright, I believe this is ready to get lowered back down onto the trailer. I went through, I took out all the old carpet and just cut the last few screws and nails that were going to be in the way, and I cut some new blocks to go where there was some rot. There's one piece I can't put on until this thing's in the air off the blocks. The things that could happen here that wouldn't be good would be A, it's not going to fit. I think my measurements are good, we'll see. B, because this is tilted a little downhill, it could be very hard to line this up. And so I think what I'm gonna do is strap this thing from the far side up high to the close side down low through the wheel well, and just kind of use that as a way to keep this from sliding downhill. I'll probably run a couple straps inside just to kind of reinforce it from falling down. If you guys remember when we took this out, it was too low for me to be able to just roll the trailer right out, and so I had to let the air out of the tires. The same will likely be true here, so I'm gonna get it lined up as best I can, as straight as I can. It's probably gonna take 6 or 8 tries, and then I will remove the cores from the valve stems and drain all the air out, and we'll see if we can get this thing lined up. All right, this is not going too well. I've tried a couple times to line this up, to let the air out of the tires and to back it under, but because it's on an incline, once I let the air out, it seems like it just kind of drifts downhill as I back it in. And when it's doing that, it actually hit one of the concrete things on the other side. I scraped one of the wheels a little bit. I scraped the side of the frame a little bit. It's not ideal all the way around. And now I'm probably about 6 feet from being all the way back in, and it slid down of 3 or 4 inches, and I'm trying to figure out how to get it out without scraping it again on the other side. So I think I'm just gonna have to keep trying. I have to air the tires up to make these like big moves, but I can't get it under with the tires aired up. So I already had one pop off the bead, and I had to put the thing back in and fight with it and put air in it till it caught again and aired back up. But this is not working out real well. I think in hindsight I should have probably had a wider path here, but I didn't want it to be so wide that it would be too much weight on those 4x4s. So I guess I'm gonna try to pull it out again, try to line it up, and I think I'm just gonna go on the high side. I may have to just get it really close and then move the body a little bit. I'm not sure, but this is not going super well. We are in the camper. We are ready to drop this thing. We're gonna do a similar setup as last time. We've got 6 jacks. There's 2 scissor jacks in the back, 2 in the front, and then bottle jacks in the middle. I could probably do this with 4, but I'd rather just have the extra support and stability. The biggest risk as I see it here is that while we're only 6 or 8 inches up off the deck, as you can see, the jacks are pretty high up. They're like probably almost 2 feet off the ground, and they're on blocks. And so worst case is that this thing tips to the side. To try to avoid that, I've added these ratchet straps here that go up to the ceiling and down to the suspension on each side. The idea being that as I lower it, I'll tighten them. I should be able to use that to shift it from one side to the other. And hopefully that will prevent it from getting unstable. Before I can do anything, I'm gonna lift, and I've got screws from the bottom plate into each of these 4x4s. So I'll take those screws out, I'll put a little tension on the jacks, we'll lift it up maybe a half inch, and we'll slide out these 4x4s. Once those are out, I've got one more piece of bottom plate that's got to go on over here where it's currently on a 4x4 and I couldn't get to. And then once that happens, we're going to start bringing this down little by little. So I'm not going to talk much during this. This is going to be a lot of running around, and it's going to be probably a pretty stressful process. So I'm just going to let the camera roll. wish me luck. Holy cow, that was a workout. That was about 2.5 hours of just running around, messing with the jacks, and the whole thing, just depending on how you jacked it, it would twist and move. And so I was having to screw D-loops down to the floor and use ratchet straps to pull it, but I can only pull it so much without the jack starting to tip. And so I had to be really cautious with how I pulled it. I'd have to pull it and then relieve the tension on one jack at a time. And at one point I almost lost it. I opted to set one side down first, the driver side, and I thought the weight would hold that, but when I started to pull on the other side to get it to where I needed to be, the driver side, about half or two-thirds of it actually fell off the side. And thankfully I was standing next to this, I was able to grab it, pull some of the weight, and I had an extra scissor jack that had been taken out next to me. And so I grabbed that and got it under it, and then was able to use a strap to pull it back. But that was absolutely exhausting. The good news is that at first glance, everything fits. So let's take a look around and I'll show you guys how it all worked out. Okay, back corner, it's weird seeing solid floor here. This has been rotten the whole time I've had it. You can see there's actually quite a bit of extra room here. It looks like a lot more than it is. There's maybe a quarter inch by the time it comes in. This whole wall has just a tremendous amount of flex to it because there's no framing, which is kind of scary because that was holding it up. Over here, it's a little tighter. So we may have to shift the passenger side forward a little. What's amazing to me, I really thought I got this wrong as I was setting it down. That's within about an eighth. That's within probably less than a 16th. When I come over to the other side, you can see the whole thing is shifted back about a quarter. So I think probably I'm gonna try to use straps to pull that side forward, but I wanna make sure this side is fully attached first. That's probably not gonna be something I do today. I'm just exhausted. We got a little extra room up front here, nothing crazy. That was a little loose before and was caulked. Same thing up there. Let's check out outside. All right, there she is. Looks just like it should. Everything from out here looks good. Even the wheel wells actually look improved because the axles, if you remember, got shifted backwards. So before, it was way closer up front than it was in the back. It's still about an inch closer up front, but it improved that by a half inch or an inch or so. So I'm gonna call it a day there. I think this thing should be safe. I'll come back to it tomorrow, make some final adjustments and get it screwed down. Okay, I've got three screws in the passenger side. I'm gonna remove the driver's side. I've only got two screws in here right now, so they shouldn't take long. All right, so the driver's side is just sitting here now. There's nothing holding this down. I'm gonna see if I can just grab this and just scoot it forward just a teeny tiny bit. Okay, so I overestimated my strength a little bit here. That's not gonna work. So now I have to make the decision of, do I want to try to use a ratchet strap to push this forward, or do I just wanna leave it? I think I'm going to take a look outside and see how things line up and see how it's looking all around before I make that call. Okay, so looking at it around the outside, it's if anything, this driver's side is pretty far forward. It's fairly tight in the back, so I don't think I want to force the issue and push this forward. I don't want to come back either though, because I'm flush here and I'm behind the wheel well there. So I'm at a point where it'd be pretty easy to mount the wheel well and it'll work outside. The passenger side, however, definitely needs to get shifted a little bit forward. which the wheel well agrees with, and the front and the back corners both agree with. So I'm gonna get this side pinned, get it screwed down for real, get it lined up real nice, and then we'll probably use a ratchet strap to get that side going. I'll show you guys my setup here. Driver's side is all screwed down. I've taken three ratchet straps and I've run them passenger to driver to keep the bottom of this together. They're not real secure, but it doesn't need much. I've removed all the screws from the bottom plate along the wall on the passenger side. And now what I've done is I've screwed a hook here and I've run a strap back to a fairly secure spot here in the frame. So the goal here is by putting tension on that and maybe pulling a little bit myself, we can take that gap and that gap and get them even. So give it a shot here. I don't know if this is gonna work. I'm also worried about the fact that my hook's already lifting up a little bit, just a little bit of pressure. So I may need to relocate that where I can get two screws, but we're gonna give this a shot. Shoot, that actually worked. I did have to move my D-ring sideways, put another screw in it. But we are real good there. Looks good on the outside. So I ended up having to take a block and hit it when it was under tension, and that was just enough to move it. Ratchet strap wasn't quite enough. So just like on the other side, we're just gonna go along and correct this issue. But I was able to pretty much just pull that in by hand. See if I can do it here. Yeah, it's gonna be a little bit of a fight, but we'll get it in. We'll pull them in and get screws in this whole side. I am very excited because now at this point I can confidently say it fits. The body fits on the frame exactly how I hoped it would. There are, you know, maybe some eighth inch little differences around the wheel wells that are not going to be a big deal at all. I had intentionally made this thing about an eighth to a quarter short lengthwise because I really just didn't want that to be an issue, and it's exactly where it landed. So I'm really happy. I've checked all sides and it looks like all of the corners and everything are gonna be able to push in and touch the frame no problem. Super excited. It's crazy to think that it's come this far. Like I said at the beginning of this process, I said I would never do this, but now that I've done it, I'm just so glad that I did. To look around and see all new flooring and all new screws, and there's no like trying to figure out how am I going to lift this up and put a new piece of wood under and make it all strong again. All of the frame underneath the floor is rock solid. I was even able in this back passenger corner to pull up the floor a little bit where it had sagged just a little. So I'm just really excited. This turned out really, really awesome. So I'm going to clean up a little bit and then figure out my next plan from here.